Welcome to Oracle APM tutorial series. In this video, I would like to demonstrate how you can set up a synthetic monitor, how to use the data collected by the monitor, also how to create dedicated vantage point. My name is Yutaka Takatsu. I'm one of the product managers in Observability and Management product management team in Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. Here is the program agenda. First, I will create a synthetic browser monitor and demonstrate how to use the data collected by that monitor. Second, I will show you how to create a dedicated vantage point in your own tenancy. In this demo, I would like to show you how to create a synthetic monitor. A monitor can be created in the synthetic monitoring page in Oracle Cloud Console. This is also the page where you can see the status of your existing monitors. In this example, there are 6 monitors configured in the APM domain. You can see the status, interval, and number of the vantage point for each monitor. I will go ahead and create a monitor. First, name your monitor. And select the monitor type. I'm going to select the browser monitor. Next, type in a URL that you want to test against with this monitor. And make sure that you type in the entire URL, including HTTP. You can also specify a text in the verify response content field. This will help you to make sure the right page is loaded. Click Next. The first option in this section is to select the vantage points which you want to run your monitor. You can select multiple locations from the pull-down menu. And if you already configured the dedicated vantage point that runs in your own tenancy, that will show up in this list as well. Then configure the frequency, how frequent you want to run the monitor, by specifying an interval between the monitor runs. I'll keep the default values. And you can also enable the network collection option. This option executes the trace rule against the base URL of the monitor and provides a report. It provides the valuable information to troubleshoot in case of network issues. Okay, click Next. You can add tags if you wanted to. Review the configurations and click Create. Okay, so the monitor is created. Next, let's see the synthetic monitor's dashboard. Here is the dashboard page which lists default and custom dashboards. I'm going to select monitor's dashboard. And the monitor dashboard shows overview status of the synthetic monitors running in an APM domain. So once your monitor starts collecting synthetic data, you can start analysis with this dashboard. The bar chart at the upper left side of the screen shows the number of runs and whether they have succeeded or failed. And the one next to it shows the vantage points where the monitors were run. So if you see the monitor is failing at all locations, you might have a connection issue towards your application. A graph in the upper right side displays execution time of the monitor. So if you see spikes, that indicates some part of your application is not performing well. And to see more details, there are breakdown charts. The load time breakdown is closely related to the execution time. So in this example, you can see a spike with blue color, which indicating the AJAX calls are slowing down. And in case of the network issues, connection time breakdown chart can help you to analyze the root cause. The failures in the monitor runs can be caused by the SSL not being resolved or an issue in DNS. Also, longer execution time may be causing the delay in the connection. And looking at the list of the monitors, this WineStore E2E monitor seems to be the slowest. So let's take a look at this monitor by clicking the monitor name. This opens the monitor page. Scroll down to see the history of the executions. So this history section, you can see all the execution of this monitor. And you can also filter the executions, such as the time range, by the status, or by the vantage points. And in case of the slow monitor run or failed monitor run, there are options to diagnose what's going on. For example, you can see the error message in case of the failed script run, or trace details in case of the network issues. You can also see the HAR file and also the screenshots. You can also download the browser console logs. So here, let's review the HAR file. This will open the Hard Viewer in the Oracle Cloud Console. And Hard File, or the HTTP archive file, stores the information regarding user action performed on the browser. APM adopted to collect Hard File at the monitor executions and visualizes in this page. In the upper side of the screen, there are pie charts showing load time breakdown information. And in the steps section, it shows requests with details such as request type URL, response code, elapsed time, and if you click the URL, it shows the HTTP header information. And there is also a camera icon at the end of the row, which opens a screenshot information captured at the time of the run. And this is where you see the error pages, such as internal server error in case of the failed monitor runs. Let's close this window. Let's close the Hard File. The Hard File provides a lot of useful information to diagnose or troubleshoot your performance issues in your web applications. However, in case the root cause is at the back end, it requires investigation in the application server. So if you have configured APM Tracer on the application, you can use the View Trace Details option to navigate to the Trace Explorer page directly from this monitor history page. And this seems to be the slowest run in the list, so let's see the traces for this monitor run. View Trace Details. And here open the Trace Explorer, and because we navigated from the Monitor History run page, the query was automatically created to display the result of the particular monitor run. I can see the monitor ID or the Vantage Point. And let me sort with the duration. And looking at the main section, there is a trace at the top row where it took 16 seconds to complete. This may be one of the requests of the slow monitor runs, which we were seeing in the monitor page. So let's click the operation name to see the details. So looking at the spans in the Gantt chart, it is obvious that one of the spans was taking most of the seconds. And from the operation name, this seems to be a JDBC span, and looks like it's a database update statement, which is a part of the checkout service. So this seems to be the root cause of the slowness, but you can also see the database related dimensions from the span. So I'm going to click the bar of this span, scroll down, and here you can see the diagnostic details of the span, which includes database connection string or SQL ID, which you may want to use to further diagnose the database. As a next topic, I would like to show you how to create a dedicated vantage point. You can create a dedicated vantage point from the synthetic monitoring page in Oracle Cloud Console. Make sure you are in the right compartment and APM domain. Then click the dedicated vantage points link under resources. If you are not an Oracle Cloud Administrator, as a prerequisite, you will need your administrator to create a policy which allows you to create a dedicated vantage point and grant the policy to you or to your user group. And before starting the wizard, you will need to gather the information such as VCN details, authentication token, APM domain OCID, and private key of your APM domain. Please also check if the VCN, which you want a dedicated vantage point to run, allows direct communication to the APM domain data endpoints. If it doesn't, you'll need to set up a proxy to have the communication to go through. So in that case, you'll need to gather the proxy server information as well. And once these details are collected, you can start the wizard by clicking a link to create an APM dedicated vantage point. And this will open Create the Stack Wizard page. And in the wizard, you'll need to follow the instructions to configure the entities such as VCN, APM domain, OKE, or proxy, along with other information. The first page in the wizard already has a setting preselected, including the stack template for DVP. So unless you want to change the default settings, you can select Next to go to the next page. In Configure Variables section, first name your dedicated vantage point. Then select Network Compartment. And VCN. Here, make sure to select the public subnet. In the domain configuration, enter your authentication token and domain private data keys. And here it has to be a specific JSON format, as in the example in the text file. So please note the OCID of the APM domain and also the private data key has to be collected in prior. So I'm going to copy this text and paste into the field. Next is the OKE configuration. Here you need to define how many nodes you want in the cluster. The minimum desired is 2, and you can increment if you have more than 30 or 50 monitors running simultaneously. The number depends on the type of monitors you run. For example, the script browser type is consuming more resources than other monitor types. Here, select my SSH key and the proxy. The proxy is not required, but if the target application you want to monitor requires application access through a proxy, even within the specified VCN, then set up the proxy is required. And vault configuration, this is also optional, but it is needed if your script have secrets or encrypted object specified. And last two options are pre-checked. Log configuration is checked, so you can potentially diagnose runtime issues with your dedicated vantage point. And auto upgrade is checked to ensure your dedicated vantage point automatically gets the latest synthetic Docker image imported. So once you enter all the required information, click Next. And verify the configuration. Click Run, Apply, Create. And this will launch the resource manager job to start the provisioning of the dedicated vantage point. The process will take around 45 to 50 minutes to complete. Once the provisioning is completed and your dedicated vantage point is created, you can use it to run your monitors within your VCN, within or connected to your protected environment. This concludes the demonstration of creating and using a synthetic monitor, also creating a dedicated vantage point in APM service. We have more videos discussing and demonstrating APM features. Please see the description of this video to find links to other APM tutorial videos. Thank you for watching.